Good morning, Tatu.
Boss, who are they?
Mr. and Mrs. Weston from Phoenix, Arizona. They are newlyweds.
Did they come here to have their honeymoon?
I only wish they had.
Why? What's their fantasy?
They hope to discover the secret of eternal youth so they can be together for all time. If they succeed, it could mean exactly the opposite.
That lady looks kind of shy, boss.
Very shy, Tatu. That is Miss Margaret Winslow, a file clerk from Salem, Oregon.
That must be quite boring.
Well, apparently Miss Winslow finds it boring, which is why she seeks escape in the movies.
Oh, her fantasy is to become a movie star?
No, not quite, Tatu. She wishes to have a date with Bert Hunter.
Like the double agent Simon Flynn?
Well, yes, that is the role Mr. Hunter is best known for playing, yes.
Boss, can I meet him? I'm a big fan of his.
In due time, Tatu. This is Miss Winslow's fantasy, remember? A fantasy which may take some rather unexpected turns. My dear guests, I am Mr. Rourke, your host. Welcome to Fantasy Island.
Understand, Mr. Rourke. I've never felt about anyone the way I do about Diana. We're alike in so many ways.
What kind of work do you do?
Alex is an architect and I'm an interior decorator. We have our own firm now, and we spend all day and all night together.
And we want it to stay that way. Forever.
A lot of people die looking for the Fountain of Youth.
That was right. I caution you. Cherish what you have. Don't risk it for something that's probably a mere myth.
Oh, we believe that all myth is founded in the truth, Mr. Rourke.
Can you help us?
There is an island to the south of here, very remote, totally cut off from civilization as we know it. A local legend says that the people who settled there came from a powerful and mystical land far, far away. Perhaps you will find what you are seeking there. But I must warn you, it could be very, very dangerous.
When do we leave?
Now, if you go into the pool and dive under the water, your fantasy will begin.
Mr. Rourke.
Please. Please, do as I say.
Mr. It's Egyptian. The god Osiris. It's thousands of years old. I wonder how it got here. Hey, wait a minute. Do you speak English?
Who sounded the alarm?
I did. I saw these strangers in the sacred pool of Osiris.
How did they get past you?
They didn't. They just came up out of the water.
Take them to the queen.
Wait!
Take the woman to Natura. You too. Bring the man and follow me.
Oh, Alex!
I cannot imagine what it's like working in a file room all day. I mean, I don't even have a window. I guess that's why I love the movies so much. You know, they really keep me going, especially Bert Hunter movies. Oh, the way he plays that part. You know, I think I have dreamt about being one of Simon Flynn's heroines in every film.
What concerns me, Miss Winslow, is that you seem to have substituted the illusion of films for the reality of your life.
Maybe. But I'm happy. And I will be even happier when I get to meet Bert. Oh, he is my ideal. You know, the kind of man who knows what a woman wants and needs without...
Miss Winslow, even if that were true, your fantasy will last only for the weekend. When it's over, what then?
I will go back to the movies and I will have my memories.
Very well, then. Will you come with me, please? Mr. Bert Hunter is waiting for us in his bungalow.
What? Now?
But of course now.
Tremendous responsibility being a star tattoo. I supervise all my scripts, do most of my own stunts.
You must be very dangerous.
Sure. The fans expect it. Each movie I make has to be more spectacular than the last.
Vodka on the rock with a twist of lime, no lemon, just like you like it, right?
Why, you know your Simon Flynn very well, don't you?
Oh, he's my favorite movie star. And right over here, a TV monitor, just like Simon Flynn.
It's great, it's great.
Front door. Back door. That's perfect. Just perfect.
The boss wanted me to give you this.
You know, Tattoo, I think one of the real secrets of my success is the fact I've gotten to know my character so well. In the past few years, I have actually become Simon Flynn in real life. That's why I can't read this script. Tattoo, I want you to tell Mr. Rourke thanks, but no thanks. Excuse me. Hello? Yes, put him on. To my agent from Beverly Hills. Hello, Max. How are you? Well, that's not funny, Max. What do you mean I don't bring in the teen market? Well, what about my contract? Well, you do something about it. That's what I pay you for.
What happened?
The studio wants to replace me with a 18-year-old kid. Are you crazy? I know my last movie lost money, but the script was bad.
Uh-oh. Here comes the boss with Miss Winslow.
My life is on the line, Tattoo. I can't meet that woman now. John Pikes is on Fantasy Island, scouting locations for the next Simon Flynn picture. I've got to find him. Talk him out of this insanity.
Maybe if he knew how much Miss Winslow wants to meet you, he would see how popular you still are.
Oh. I don't know, Tattoo.
Well, maybe if you dress her up a little bit and make her look more glamorous.
It's just that I've never had to use anyone before.
Just think of it as survival. Excuse me. Oh, hi, boss.
Hello, Tatu. Miss Winslow, may I present your escort, Mr. Bert Hunter.
Oh, Mr. Rourke, it's really him.
Miss Winslow.
Prisoner to a holding cell for interrogation. There was a struggle, and he fell. Take him! Throw him in!
Actions.
I was only going to question him. He attacked me.
That's a lie.
Arrest him.
Diana, my wife.
Oh, she's perfectly safe. I'll take you to her. But first, who are you and why have you come to my island?
I'm Alex Weston. Diana and I came here looking for you. Well, it might sound fantastic.
Tell me. Tell me.
We came here to find the secret of eternal youth.
You are the man I have been waiting for. The one my dreams promised.
Dreams?
I will explain everything to you when the time is right. But for now, know that you will find what you are seeking. And more.
The only thing he'll find on this island is death.
Did you know I choose a wardrobe for all my leading ladies? I love to dress my women.
Is it really me?
I've always known I had good taste, but this time I think I've really outdone myself. You look absolutely stunning.
Oh, thank you. You know, I feel just like one of your heroines.
Well, you know, your fantasy won't be complete until I treat you like one. Maggie, I've got to tell you something. I'm not what you think I am.
Oh, no, wait a minute. I know everything about you. Your father was a ship's captain. You're a Boston blue blood, a graduate from Harvard, and... Oh, and you're even more romantic in real life than a silent flame.
Mr. Hunter? I find what Mr. Mike's gonna have dinner tonight. I make a I'll have a shoe for you and Miss Winslow. Wow, you look beautiful.
Thank you, Tattoo. Bert, he did it all.
Mr. Doctor, we have to go now. Your reservations?
Says that any strangers found on my island are to be brought directly to me. Why did you disobey me?
I worship you. I'd do anything to protect you from harm.
I have cared for you too, Ramas. For a while. As I have cared for many mortal men.
I could be so much more than the others if you'd let me. I know that the time of renewal is very soon. Matera, I'd willingly die for you, but I'd much rather be by your side to serve you and our people forever.
No. Alex will become immortal and will rule beside me as my husband.
He already has a wife.
Not for long. By this time tomorrow, she will be quite dead.
I thought maybe we could go back to the
party
room. Oh boy, pick up the menu. We're not here. Oh great,
John. Good evening.
Oh, Bert, what a surprise. You know my assistant, Yvonne?
Oh, yes, Yvonne, of course. How are you doing?
A lot better than you.
John, there's someone I'd like you to meet. Margaret Winslow, that's my director, John Pike.
Hiya, doll. How are you?
May we join you? Buy you a drink.
Yeah.
Oh, excuse me. Tattoo, how is Miss Winslow's fantasy progressing?
Fine, boss. Hi.
Hi, Tattoo, Mr. Orr.
Hello, Christy.
Christy, what are you doing here?
You know I never eat junk food, but today I got this incredible craving for chocolate sundaes.
Two of them?
Yeah, and I'm still hungry. But I already used up all my allowance.
Oh.
You couldn't float me alone, could you? I really think I could eat one more.
One more? Oh, I'm afraid I left my wallet in the office. I'm terribly sorry, Christy.
Tattoo, what are you looking at?
Oh, that's a Bert Hunter. He's a famous movie star. He's also my best friend.
He is? Really?
Boss.
He does look kind of familiar.
He played that double agent Simon Flynn in the movies.
Do you think you'll get his autograph for me?
Of course. I can also do better than that. Come on. Excuse me, Mr. Hunter. This is Christy. She's a big fan of yours.
Well, well. What a pretty young lady you are, Christy.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Hunter. I don't have an autograph book, but maybe you could sign your name on one of the menus, so I'll always remember where I met you.
You bet, Christy. How about that one? To Christy, from your friend, Bert Hunter.
Thanks. The chef is just crazy about Simon Flynn movies. I bet I can trade this for a month of sundaes.
Excuse me.
Smart kid. Terrific. Look, Bertie, gotta go, huh? We'll just leave you to your fans. All two of them. Come on, doll.
I think I'm falling in love with you. I mean, you're just about the kindest, most considerate man I've ever met.
Oh, Mag, stop it. Don't you know better than to believe everything you see?
Tira, this place is incredible. It's like walking into a living time capsule. Little bits of Egypt, Rome, and Greece, all in the present day. Where did your people originally come from?
When Egypt was invaded by Persia, the pharaoh, Nekeruhem, fled to the south, past the great pyramids and the splendors of Karnak, until he reached the Nubian coast. He was never heard of again.
Yes. That's one of Egypt's great unsolved mysteries.
We hired Phoenician ships and sailed for many years until we found this island. It is not history for me, but a memory.
Tira, are you trying to tell us something?
I am the Pharaoh's half-sister. Our mother came to Egypt from Rome. My father, her lover, was Alexander the Great.
But that would mean that you're over 2,000 years old.
Everyone leave me, except this man.
Alex, you don't have to stay here. Alex, don't let them separate us.
You'll be all right. You go ahead, darling.
I alone hold the secret of immortality, and I must judge who can partake of its miracle. Soon, I will bathe in the life-giving waters of the pool, and I will be again as I was in Thebes, as a girl, when I was barely 18. It will be the same for you. Live forever. Open it, my darling, and you will see the man I have dreamed of for over 2,000 years. It's a picture of you. Centuries ago, the man I love.
Forgive me?
I never thought I'd see you again.
When I've come to take you to the car show, there it is.
Yes, I remember. It's from your film, Island Marauders.
Right.
Really? Have all these gadgets in?
Okay, let's see. A little bit handheld. Shot widens over here. Down this way.
Look, there's a 1939 Lincoln. Isn't that something? Let's take a look at that.
Beautiful.
And a car.
Maybe a 16. Oh, what's he gonna do this time? Phew.
Take a hike, Buster. This is my girl.
Hey, I don't even know you.
Well, give me time, honey. You will.
Will you let go of me?
All right, that's enough. That's enough. Just stand back over there.
Wow. Hey, Bertsy. Wow, that was something.
Yeah, well.
It's not going to work, though. You see, I used that stuntman 3 years ago in Mallorca Mayhem.
Stuntman?
Come on, doll.
Stuntman? What did he mean, stuntman?
I faked the fight, Maggie. You're going to take the part away from me. Give it to some kid. I had to do something. Maggie, you. Go after him. Tell him how you feel about me. How you like my pictures, you know.
I can't believe this. I thought
thought that you were the most wonderful, honest, real man that I'd ever met. You're a phony. You bought me this outfit. You made me tell the director how I was dying to meet you. You used me the same way you used that stuntman. Only he got paid for it. Look, I don't want to see you or one of your pictures ever again.
I assure you, Miss Winslow, if you will just stay until the weekend is
stay.
Over.
Wait. Stay for what? My fantasy is a bust. I mean, I have never been so humiliated in all my life. Look, all I want is my money back so that I can leave here and forget this whole thing ever happened.
I am truly sorry. I will write you a check immediately, of course.
You! I told you I never wanted to see you again!
Mr. Rourke, if you don't mind, could you leave us alone for a few minutes, please?
Oh, certainly. I have other matters to attend to anyway. Feel free to use my office as long as you wish. Will you excuse me?
Now, I want you to stay here and listen to everything I have to say.
Oh! Like hell I will.
My father was a plumber, not a ship's captain. I'm no blue blood, Maggie. I'm just a kid from the Bronx who took some voice lessons and got lucky. I've been a fool. I've been living on nerve and lies for too long now. I haven't done my own stunts in 10 years. I've never used anybody in my life, Maggie. And you can believe this. You're the last person on earth I'd ever want to hurt.
It did hurt. I felt like nothing. I came here to get away from that feeling. I've been nothing all my life.
No. You're a lovely woman. You know, I think you're the most honest, genuine, real woman I've ever met. When I realized what I had done, what I had stooped to...
No, wait. I might start to cry. I mean, I always cry in the tender scenes.
You know, maybe the studio was right. Maybe it is the kids who are buying all the tickets today, more than anybody else. Well, anyway, I've decided to bow out, retire. So my fans and you can remember me at my best. Think you can ever forgive me?
I think I could forgive you almost anything.
Well, then this will be the last thing my Simon Flynn ever does. It'll always belong to you, Maggie.
My soul.
Oh, help us get out of here. Take us back to the pool and we'll leave.
How?
The same way we came. Look, I can't explain it to you now, but can't you see without Alex here, you'd have Matera all to yourself?
Unchain this woman, Ramos. Waiting, resting.
I want to see him. I want to see him.
No. You came here to rob me of my secret, and now you must pay.
Keep your secrets. Just let us go.
The price of immortality is high.
Please.
Because I am merciful, only one of you has to die. Either you drink this poisoned wine, Or you watch while Alex does.
If I do, what will happen to Alex?
Your sacrifice will bring him eternal life. Choose.
Winslow, have you decided to stay after all?
Yes. Look, Bert's doing something terrible. He needs your help, Mr. Rourke.
Oh? Well, what about your fantasy?
Oh, I don't care about that anymore. Look, he's decided to give up acting, and somehow I feel responsible.
Mr. Hunter has been playing one role for nearly 15 years, Miss Winslow. Perhaps it's time for him to make a change, don't you think?
Miss seeing him in the movies, and I know a lot of other people would too. He's just too good to quit.
Yes, I'm afraid it's his decision to make, not yours or mine.
But if he could only be made to see that there must be other parts he could play.
Well, as a matter of fact, I have a script in my office with a part in it that would be perfect for him, but I haven't been able to get him to even look at it.
Would you let me try?
Has Matera sent you? Is it time?
Mr. Weston. Don't you know who I am?
No. You seem familiar somehow, but...
And your wife, Diana. Where is she, Mr. Weston?
I'm going to marry Matera.
Perhaps this will help. Look at it, Mr. Weston. Now look at the ring on your own finger.
They're identical. I don't understand.
The Queen has been using the jewel in her necklace to hypnotize you. Now try to remember, Mr. Weston. Remember Diana and the great love between you. Remember before it's too late.
What happened to her? Where is she? Mr. Rourke, help me! Mr. Rourke?
Alex! Alex, my darling. The time of renewal is drawing near.
What have you done with my wife?
You have no wife but Matera.
That's a lie! Oh! You tell me what you've done with Diana.
She's gone.
Where?
She left the island.
Look, I want the truth, and I want you to tell me now. You can forget your promises. I don't want to live without Diana.
But you will. Mr. Rourke, I'm frightened. What if I can't find the right words?
Mr. Rourke?
Maybe help is on the way.
Miss Winslow, this is Christy.
Oh, I remember you. You're the little girl that asked for Bert's autograph last night at dinner.
Right. And you're his girlfriend, aren't you?
Well, just now I'm trying to be his friend.
Tattoo kind of told me what happened. I thought maybe these would help.
Oh, are these for me?
Mr. Hunter.
You know, that's a lovely idea. Whatever made you think of it?
Mr. Rourke always says, beautiful things make beautiful feelings happen. I hope it's okay to give flowers to a guy.
I'd say it's immensely okay. Of course, there's really only one way to find out. Isn't there?
Yeah.
Good luck. Come on, Tattoo. I've got a quarter. I'll flip you for treats on a soda.
Oh, goody. Let's go.
Wait for me.
Pretty good.
You are still pretty good. Hi.
Hi. Those for me?
Yes.
Well, I'll say, I've never gotten flowers before. You know, I think I like it a lot.
Here. Read this. Mr. Rourke says that this could be the beginning of an entire new career for you.
I don't think so, Maggie. See, before Simon Flynn came along, I was, just another starving actor. Drove truck, did odd jobs, never finished college. If I hadn't landed that role, I would probably be a bum now. Do you understand, Maggie? Without him, I am nobody. Nothing.
You're wrong! You are exactly who and what you are as Bert Hunter that made the role exciting. You created Simon Flynn, not the other way around. I love you.
Enough to marry me. You know, I've saved up plenty of money. We could travel, and I could show you the real world.
Can I give you my answer tonight?
If your answer is yes. Hey, Maggie. I need you.
Probably more than I've ever needed anything in my life.
Well, if Mr. Hunter refuses to read the script, I guess there is nothing else we can do, Miss Winslow.
Oh, but there is. We have got to convince that director to cast Bert as Simon Flynn again.
How can that help now?
Oh, look, if Bert marries me now, I don't want it to be because he thinks he's a has-been. I don't want him to settle for second best. I've done that all my life.
If I do what you ask, Miss Winslow, you might lose him.
It's a chance I'm willing to take. Mr. Rourke, please, just make him look like a hero. One more time.
Very well. Why don't you take him to the antique car show tonight?
Osiris, ancient one, as you were reborn so many eons ago, so will we be reborn tonight for all eternity.
she's dead.
If you take your wife into the pool now, she may live again, but you'll forfeit the immortality Matura has offered you.
You mean I can bring Diana back to life?
Yes, if you hurry.
Diana, I love you.
No!
Long life to you both.
I will die!
We owe you a debt of eternal gratitude.
Alex, look into the water.
Mr. and Mrs. Weston, the fantasy is over. Dive into the water quickly.
You have no idea how good it is to see you both.
Okay, Maggie, when do I get my answer?
Soon, I hope.
Yeah.
Now take it easy, Mr. Hunter, and nobody gets hurt. You're gonna go with us.
Come on, will you guys? Now buzz off. This is not a good time for gags. It's my director, Practical Joe.
This ain't no joke, superstar.
We figured the studio paid big bucks to get you back. Now you move, or we rough up the lady.
Okay, Maggie. Go get Mr. Rourke. Tell him to call the police.
Well, I'm sweating, man. You're the one we want.
I'm gonna put a stop to this.
Be back.
Okay, Bert. That guy's not faking it. He can still pack a wallop.
All right. Who put you up to this?
It was the boss's idea. You were fabulous, Mr. Hunter.
Thanks, Tattoo.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? This has been a special demonstration by one of your favorite actors, Mr. Bear Hunter, as double agent Simon Flynn in real live action. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Enjoy yourselves.
You're really something, Mr. Hunter.
Thanks.
Bert. I'm convinced. You still got what it takes. Listen, I know a great plastic surgeon. He'll take a couple of tucks here, a couple of tucks there. We'll get at least two pictures for you, huh?
Thanks, John. Thank you very much, but I don't think so. I have another script in mind for my next project. Excuse me.
Bert.
Well, do I get my answer now?
Oh, yes.
Mr. Rourke, how can we ever thank you?
You mean they found it? They're gonna live forever?
We found a tattoo, but the price was just too high, so we passed.
We decided to stop worrying about when it's gonna end and enjoy every moment of our love as it comes.
I think you've made a very wise decision. Remember, a poet once said, "Grow old with me. The best is yet to be."
Thanks again.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
thank you enough, Mr. Rourke.
That goes for me too, Mr. Rourke. It seems you've given me two careers and a wife. I hope you'll be very happy together.
Thank you.
And thank you, partner.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Tattoo, are you going to act in Mr. Hunter's next picture?
No, boss. I gave that idea up.
Really? Well, I thought you had mapped out a promising career for yourself.
Well, after I find out what show business is all about, you know, it's all glamour on the outside. I don't think I can take the whole pressure.